Hi everyone, welcome back to XGate Dental. I'm Emmanuel Kadosh, and we are here to discuss new procedures in the field of dentistry. We will provide interesting new cases to exhibit how doctors use our products to solve complicated dental cases. Don't forget to subscribe and follow and stay up to date. Let's get right into things. Here we see a very old bridge that was probably made from zirconia with a gingiva foam composite material. You can see all the pigmentation, you can see the colors that it absorbed during the years. And when we removed the bridge, we saw from the teeth that it was based on that there was not much left. So these teeth are pretty much hopeless and we're gonna need to extract them and make implants. And here you can see the teeth after they have been removed from the bridge. You can also see that she had a couple of short bridges in the posterior area areas on multi-units here, on two implants, and they're on three. And you can see the teeth after some preparation and cleaning. The metal parts on the incisors are the teeth that had the root canal treatment a long time before the previous bridge was made, and they had a post and core installed in the root canal treatment for better fixation of the bridge. So why make a bridge and not just remove all the teeth and make a denture? Well, first of all, you have a posterior implant. You always want to have an implant-based denture. A bridge is also a denture, but implant-based. So to make a full denture for this case, it wouldn't hold. She wouldn't have a satisfying function with dentures. So we would never honestly do that. Here you have a lot of bone, so you can just replace the old bridge with a new bridge based on enough implants. You have posterior implants and you just need to add three or four implants in the interior area and you should have enough implants to hold. Now, you can see that what we chose to do is to extract those teeth and leave for now the two central incisors, because for the provisional bridge, for the temporary restoration, you wanna make the restoration on those implants, but you can make a horseshoe like this without any interior support. You will just press on the gingiva on the implants and it can harm the implant that are installed above this bridge. So we have those two teeth remaining. We just made a bridge that was made with two implants on one side, three on the other side, and frontal area on two teeth. So it's not possible. You need to think about different solutions. You can see here the two teeth. You can see three implants, two implants, and this was made on a gypsy model, which was made with CAD/CAM. All the designing and the milling was done on the computer. We had a computer-based design. We had manufacturing computer aids, but the scanning, the impression part was traditional. You don't need to have an intraoral scanner to make this type of work. Sometimes it's even easier for some cases because you don't need to maintain all the liquids and blood and saliva that you have in the mouth while you scan with the intraoral scanner. You just have your silicone, your transfers, and you just take impressions and it works perfectly. Then you have a gypsy model and you scan it, or you scan the tray with the silicone or the impressions. You can even scan the gypsy model afterwards, but you don't need to have an intraoral scanner to make complicated procedures. Today, almost every laboratory has a technical scanner like a desktop scanner, and it's good enough for everything that you need. Here you can see the temporary bridge. Now you have some space between the gingiva and the bridge because you want to have it heal properly and for the patient to have the ability to maintain and clean the bridge. In this case, after the extraction, the implants were made. You need to wait 3 to 4 months for the osseointegration and the healing process to complete. Now, the hole is from the old implants, which you see here. We have made a temporary bridge right on top of the implant that she had with the multi-unit that she already had. The front teeth we made exactly as they were before. They were offset before. So here we mark the offset. Now, to correct the offset before the provisional bridge is very hard. You're probably wondering if the two front teeth will hold the bridge. Well, for 2 to 3 months to wait for the implants to go through the osseointegration or the whole process, yeah, it will hold. You don't have any other option, really. You need to assess if the teeth are good enough to hold and maintain this period of time, because if the teeth are in caries, you can't do these teeth. You can make a permanent restoration that can guarantee success, but the front teeth were made exactly as they were before. They were a bit offset. Now, to correct the offset before this provisional bridge is very hard. First of all, because you have to remove a lot of material from two teeth because you want the width of the teeth to be exactly the same. You want them to be symmetrical, so you need to remove material from the teeth. It will interfere with the cementation process, which means it probably won't hold. You don't want to involve the teeth too much. You want to keep the old teeth and make new ones. Eventually, it looks so much better now, so there's a slight shift. Later on, we'll fix it, of course. Here you can see the multi-unit in the implant that was placed. This is after the osseointegration. You can see the gingiva had a little bit of recession. You didn't see it earlier because of the inflammation because the gingiva was very big. Now you can see the gingiva in a good color. It's quite healthy, so you have a little recession. You can see healthy tissue and you could see the minimal height of the multi-unit or angulated multi-units that's available. Because in this case, the inclination of the implant probably was buccally inclined in its interior area, in most cases, implants are buccally inclined. They used an angulated multi-unit and you can see that after the healing process, you have some recession and you can see the metal of the angulated multi-unit. So you have a very good bridge. It looks very nice, but you see the metal part of the multi-unit. We chose to anodize the multi-unit in a pink color or a tissue color. So even though you have recession, even though the metal is visible, it will mask a little bit of the reflection of the metal through the gingiva. If you have a thin gingiva, it will reflect much less and you'll see different colors. You won't see the gray color that you see in many cases when you have a titanium implant or titanium abutment. And if you have a recession, a pink color is much less visible than a metal color. This is the one that was colored. You can see these three are angulated multi-units. We took one, we colored it, and we used it for the multi-unit specifically. So you can see that for this one, you can see the recession. You can see the height of the lip, you can see the height of the horizontal part of the multi-unit, and you can also see there's about a half a millimeter recession. And when it's red, that you almost don't see it at all. You need to stretch the lip in order to see it. In this case, she has a very high line. In other cases, we probably wouldn't take this much effort to mask it because you don't see it at all. You need to raise the lip in order to see it. Making it the same color as the gingiva solves a lot of issues. Thank you everyone that joined in to learn some new and interesting information. Make sure to stay tuned for more. And of course, don't forget to subscribe, like, and follow. Thank you and see you next time.